Ted Cruz, Donald Trump. This is the last Donald Trump cartoon I drew with all of the Republican candidates. And you can go back and get the this one. And I thought I'd show you some of the other Ted Cruz's and Donald Trump's I've done. This one's one I showed before. It's a kind of a tribute to British cartoonist Steve Bell, who used to always draw George W. Bush as a monkey. I did this one as a Bell tribute. The last, second to last Donald Trump cartoon. Takes off and burns the Republicans. This is the one before that, Donald Trump with his immigration policy. This one didn't get much press because other news events took it. Donald Trump and Pied Piper with all the little Republican. Hey, Theo. You there? Theo, you there? Well, I see that my OBS is broadcasting, but it's not showing up on Twitch or Restream or YouTube. So the broadcast is live, it's showing up on OBS. It's got and it's frozen. Looks like it's okay. I've got three windows open looking at Twitch Restream and YouTube. All are blank.
Okay, so it's
Ted
the one
I'm only looking at one YouTube, which is the page we've been using. Oh! It just came up on YouTube. Very good.
Yeah, it wasn't,
okay. Keep in mind that what you say on the phone is, going out on YouTube. So can we get Restream going? Okay, so I'm eager to get Twitch going. Let's see if that's working. Okay. Chat with you on YouTube. See you later. So, hey everybody on YouTube, I think I've got no visitors yet. We're trying to get a system going where we've got Twitch working today. We haven't quite achieved. Hopefully pretty soon, but I'm going to go ahead and start on this. Oops. Lost. But it's still working on my live site. Six people are watching. Okay, people. We're trying to see if we can get the YouTube streaming to work. If you could leave a chat message and tell me if you're seeing anything now, that would be great. Otherwise, looks like it is not working. Another minute. Tech IPO. main kid is quite working. Not quite working. Ah! There it is. I think it's working. So, my apologies to all of you. So, I was showing you some of the other Trump cartoons I've done. Here he is, hanging himself with his words. This is actually an early one that didn't turn out to be too prescient, because it doesn't seem like he suffers the consequences of what. Now I'm starting to get comments. See your video. Appreciate your help. So here's another one of the media covering Trump to the consternation of the traditional Republicans. And here's Trump with Bush with his monkey on his back, which I enjoyed, although I don't think I got this drawing of Trump quite right. I think I need a little more on that. This is a oldie drawing of Trump that I did years ago, back when he was doing all this birther stuff about President Obama being born in Kenya, which is interesting because it was never any contention about President Obama's mother not being American. And so it's kind of exactly the same situation that Ted Cruz has, born to an American citizen mother in a foreign country. Although, except in Obama's case, of course, he was not born in Kenya, he was born in Hawaii. So this was what I drew back then. And I can see that I think Trump's gained a little bit of weight. He's gotten a little bit older looking, but he still has that yellow hair. Anyway, those are my past Trumps. And today's Trump, I have not done a rough sketch, so I'm going to go about this for the first time. So what I want to do is draw, just checking to see if the focus is right. Here's going to be Cruz. He's unhappily whacked in the head. Ouch. Whoosh, whoosh, whack in the head. Stars, because stars cause pain. Having a little bit of pain. Getting whacked in the head with a peach balloon. Peach balloon being welded by Donald Trump, whacking him in the head with a Canadian flag. That's my wordless version of this. In this while on the news, they're talking about sailors being held in Iran, American sailors by Iran. Don't know if that's a story or not yet. Had mechanical problems. Iran just picked him up and is helping him get the boat started. If it is, that should be what I'm drawing, even as Obama's about to start his State of the Union address. But the other cartoonists are going to be drawing State of the Union address, so I really need to do that. I do have an eye to what I need to be drawing, given what the other cartoonists were. Anyway, Trump is going to be whacking him on the head. He'll be that. was looking, right? Look like he went down with his hand. This is the thumbnail process, figuring out this in the first place. Nothing for you to be commenting on yet. All right, let's go with something like that. So here I've got... make it swing from right to left. The swing is going to go like that. Ted Cruz's head is going to get whacked down here. Suffering from it. Because I think the sting hurt so much. There was so much among Republicans. Obama was born in back to bite him. Would have thought Trump's birther background in the head is general expression. What's look? Whacked by speech balloon that looks like the Canadian flag. Trump whacking. Position probably be higher. Menacing, huh? I'll give Cruz a little more girth. Stuff out as I draw it. I haven't got anything completely laid out in my mind before us. Not getting any comments here. Watching you. Trump has swung down this way, and he swung his that way. Both Trump and a good deal of girth. I can have things up that way, or I can have both up. Think through where Trump's legs are going to be. Let's ask Yo. Needs a little bit more. space for that. If anybody watching this would, that would be Netflix. See if chat's working in Twitch. That is not. Whack. Oh, Kirk James pinstriping, dig watching the process. Okay, it looks like YouTube is probably working. I have my first comment. Thank you, Kirk James. Yeah, we're trying streaming this differently today, and it's looking like it's got some tech problems that need to be worked out. Stream okay just to YouTube, but try to stream also to Twitch. Arms would be longer. Maybe I do. Arms a little bit. That pointer on the speech balloon at any like that. That's a little better. Hey, Theo. I've got somebody chatting on YouTube. YouTube down as well? Okay, well, why don't you fix that? We'll give up on Twitch and we'll try Twitch again later when we're ready to do another test. Well, there's only two people watching now. We might as well do it now. Well, I am, but I'll give my apologies to Kirk James, and I think we need to go offline and get this working. All right. Send me a note with what I need to put in to make this go back to just YouTube. Thanks. Oh, okay. Where is it? Keyframe interval setting is set for 0. I don't see anything that says auto. Okay, set for 2. See any change there? That's going to take an hour. Yeah, because I don't have a good camera program. It doesn't save the settings on the camera, so I have to reset all the cameras from scratch. And it also doesn't have this nice thing that you get on a PC version of OBS, which is that you can set your camera up once and it'll work in all the different scenes. I have to do it individually for each scene. That's a function that you have nice on a PC and doesn't exist on the Mac. I can. That's what takes an hour. The camera settings don't save. The OBS settings save. Camera settings are in a separate camera program called Logitech Camera Settings. And that's the problem, because that doesn't save. It also doesn't have a setting that allows for me to choose one or the other camera. So in order to do each camera setting, I have to plug them in individually in USB, stop and restart the program. And then in OBS, I have to resize and reposition all of the cameras each time and reset the chroma key. So it takes an hour. Well, it's an hour. And it means I'm not really able to restart once I start. Well, I can tell you that I've spent days working on this. I don't know that more hours is going to give me a better conclusion. Well, each camera has a variety of settings. It's the size of the image, the position of the image, the brightness, contrast, zoom, all the things you'd expect to work in a camera. It has a save setting, but the save setting doesn't actually save. Well, it has a save choice, but the save choice doesn't actually save. I don't know that it ever worked for anybody. I would like to find another program that would run my my cameras, but OBS has settings for chroma key. It has settings for moving the camera around the page. Yeah, I see that right now. That's because I'm. That's one of the functions again that works in PC and not on Mac. On the PC, you have an eyedropper tool that you can just click in the image. All right. Use the solid green. Okay, well, the eyedropper isn't a choice, and I've selected the green and played around with it to get it to be the best possible, and OBS does. There's no choice of variant. Well, I'll open it right now, and I'll tell you what the choices are. Filters. All right, I have key color, select color, and key color type. They have standards. Here's, well, the broadcast now, a minute and a half later. If I choose green setting, standard, it hasn't worked as well as the, it'd look more like. That's what you wanted me to try? Well, it's recommended, but my chroma key isn't exactly the green that. I'm working on it. I'm flipping through to make it stronger to see if it'll pick up this green. I spent a few hours on this already. Well, I have an opacity setting, I have a key color spill reduction, smoothness, and similarity. Similarity is what I alter. Smoothness, okay. Oh, you want me to change that? Well, I have it set at the optimal setting. That's one of the things that I spend the most time trying to get correct. How's it looking right now? Okay. Facing the camera now. Now I'm waving at you. We got three people watching. Somebody's interested in this. All right, that's the same setting it was at before. So how do we get this working on Twitch? I made that change to 2. Well, I can stop streaming and start streaming again.